This is a Word Network special presentation. Get ready for Medina Pullings Live.
Hello, everybody. We are so excited about what the Lord is doing right here on the Word Network. You have tuned in to Medina Pullings Live, and I want you to get ready, buckle up, because the Holy Spirit is going to take you on a journey tonight. We have some powerhouses that are here with us, and we are ever so grateful. We want to give a special thank you to Mr. Kevin Adele for his kindness and helping us to share the gospel around the world. Come on, let's give it up for Mr. Kevin Adele. Well, tonight's lineup, oh boy, did you see it? Ah, we're going to have a move of God tonight. We have Bishop Jason Nelson with us tonight. And back by popular demand, Prophet Cynthia Thompson. That fireball herself, Linda Roach. My girl was here just a few weeks ago and tore the house up, Prophetess Tiffany Moria. And the glamorous, beautiful, I'm surprised she's not in Africa tonight, Jenny Hart. Come on, let's thank God for Pastor Hart. You better get ready, because tonight is a game changer. The Lord is going to shift you and catapult you to a brand new place. You're going to get instructions tonight. Yes, you are. You're going to be divinely inspired. Oh, yes. You better get ready, because what's in you is getting ready to come forth. You're going to see God in a mighty way on tonight. Tell your family, tell your kids, tell your cousins, tell Ray Ray in them. Come on. There is a move of God. Come on, get the word out. Invite them. Put it on social media. Tune into the Word Network to Medina Pullings Live. God has a word for you. Right now, get ready, because Bishop Jason Nelson is coming with the song, Pour Out Your Spirit. Stay tuned. There's more to see. God is right here with us. Bishop, put your hands together.
Come on, put your hands together like this. Is there anybody who really wants more of the Spirit of the Lord tonight? Let me teach you a song. It says, pour out your spirit in this place. Lord, pour out your spirit in this place. Overwhelm us and overtake us. Lord, overwhelm us and overtake us and fill us up. That's the whole song right there, y'all. Lord, fill us up. Yeah. Come on, help me sing. Sing, pour out.
Pour out your spirit
in this place. We're not just talking about the building, but we're talking about us. Pour out,
your spirit in this place.
That's what we want today, Lord. Overwhelm us. Say,
pour out your spirit in this place.
That's what we want, Lord. Pour out your spirit in this place. Come on now, real loud. Everybody, open up your mouth and say, overwhelm us. say.
Overflow.
Come on. Sing overflow, say.
Overflow.
Sing overflow.
Overflow.
One more time, say overflow.
Overflow.
Come on, let's set the cadence for the night. We want it, we want it.
There is no substitute for the presence of God. And I tell you, we've been having a mighty time over here at United Nations Church in Richmond, Virginia. God has been moving. And boy, oh boy, our bishop gave a word on Sunday morning. Yes, he did, sure enough. You know it was something. I'm still talking about it today. I'm telling you, it was the rhema from God. It was prophetic. It was life-changing. I'm telling you, it was empowering. And I want to give that to you. He shared with us a halftime word, a word in the, come on, the middle of the year. We're getting ready to go into 2020. And you don't have time to be playing any games. Come on here. You got to be serious about your Father's business, serious about the assignment, serious about the call, serious about the mandate. No time to waste time on foolishness. And he gave us a word on Sunday morning, and just it just catapulted us to a brand new place. I'm telling you that God was giving us favor. Favor in this season, in this halftime, that we would see 10 years worth of accomplishment in 6 months. Now I want to know if you believe tonight. I want to know if you believe today that God is able to super accelerate the move of God in your life to such a degree that it would cause you to see 10 years worth of development in 6 months. Somebody say that's the supernatural. Somebody say that's the super on the natural. Somebody say that's divine. Somebody say that takes God in the midst. Oh, come on, come on, come on. Now I want to ask you this. Do you believe that he's doing it in your life? I want you to not look behind you. Don't look at what disappointed you on yesterday. But I want you to look to Jesus and receive this word, because as God is pouring out his spirit and he's moving on his people, you got to know that this thing is impacting the world. This is not just staying in the four walls of the church. This is not just in our Sunday morning happy service. But this right here is causing you to be a high-level expert, a strategist, an innovator. Come on, a high-level problem solver, a special agent of change. In other words, they're not just calling you in for the small stuff or the little problems, but they're calling you in for the high-level situations. They're calling you a high-level strategist. Why? Because you have access to the greatest mind ever. You have the Holy Ghost on the inside of you. You have the Illuminator who causes you to be enlightened in areas that you would not have known about except he enlightened you. You better get ready. because God has put you in demand. The presence of God in your life and on your life has put you in demand. And it doesn't matter who tried to stop you. It doesn't matter who tried to block you. I'm here to tell you that they can't. God has already put you there. He's already set you there. He's already put you over there. You better get ready because God is going to use you to help and assist in reaching this end time harvest. I want you to know the power of God on your life is causing a major move even in your sphere, whether your sphere is finance or medicine or technology or education or music or the arts or the healthcare. God is sending you in, hallelujah, to cause an unimaginable shift in that place. Your records are going to break records. You're about to break records in that arena. God is causing you to be a top talent in that place. You better get ready because God's anointing, His power on you, has super favored you and set you over into some new places. Somebody say some new places, some new doors, some new friendships. Oh, yeah. You better get ready. Put your hands on your head and say, I'm a super thinker. I'm a super thinker because I am divinely inspired by the Holy Ghost. Oh, I'm not ashamed to talk about the Holy Ghost. And because the Holy Ghost is in me, He has made you a trendsetter. Oh, somebody ought to praise Him. You're getting ready to set the trend. As a matter of fact, a secret is sitting on the inside of you that's getting ready to hit the marketplace. There's a secret sitting in you, hallelujah, that's about to be exposed. And God is going to cause that thing to be magnetic. Somebody needs to shout in this place because it is the kingdom takeover. We're not asking, but we're taking. We're not asking, but we're taking. Touch three people and say it's the takeover. Touch your cabinet and say it's the takeover. Hallelujah. Touch your phone and say it's the takeover. High-five that screen with me and say it's the takeover. 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 What hell tried to stop, it's too late. It's too late. It's too late. The momentum is there. The shift is here. The Spirit of God is moving you. Oh, you better praise Him. You better praise Him. Somebody ought to bless Him tonight. Because it's not by might, nor by power, but by my Spirit, saith the Lord. Oh, you better bless His holy name. We've got the blueprint in the Word of God. We're obeying the Word of God. And by the Word of God, we are functioning and we are taking territory. And you shall see exponential growth like never before. Oh, you better get ready. You're about to bust out on the left and bust out on the right. Somebody else say, bust out on the left and bust. You better praise Him in this place. There's an outpouring of wisdom, an outpouring of knowledge, an outpouring of prophetic insight. Somebody bless Him in this place. Woo! I feel the power of the Holy Ghost. I feel the power of the Holy Ghost. I feel the power of the Holy Ghost. Bless Him in this place. Bless Him in this place. Bless Him right where you are. Bless Him in your home. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory, glory, glory. There's a mantle on you. There's a mantle on you. And the mantle is called supernatural favor. Supernatural favor. Supernatural favor. You've been cloaked with favor. You have access. You shall not be denied. God has set you up and set you over. Oh, somebody ought to act like you're walking in favor. Oh, somebody ought to act like you're blanketed in favor. He's wrapped you in favor. He set you before kings. He set you in high places. He set you at the top. He positioned you for the blessing. He positioned you to take possession. You're taking possession. You're taking possession. Oh, somebody ought to praise Him for the favor. Somebody ought to praise Him for the favor. The favor like that was on Joseph. You've been in the pit, but now you're going to the palace. Somebody ought to praise Him. You've been mantled with favor. Oh, somebody ought to bless His name. It's our honor to give you glory. It's our honor to give you praise. The anointing will cascade all around you. There's an outpouring. There's a cascading anointing in this place. There's a cascading anointing coming on you right where you are right now. Receive it. Receive it. taking over. We're not trying to fit in, we're taking over. I'm not ashamed to praise him. I'm not ashamed to praise him. Not ashamed to bless him. Hallelujah. The cascading anointing. Hallelujah. There's an outpour. There's an outpour. There's an outpour. There's an outpour. Oh, hallelujah. And this anointing is going with you everywhere that you go. This favor is going with you everywhere that you go. Yeah, 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 yeah. Healing, deliverance, miracles, breakthroughs. The Lord orders your steps. Hallelujah. It's kingdom dignity and dominion. We're not afraid to be sold out. We're not afraid to be all in for Jesus. It's our honor. Hey, we don't touch everything. We don't get involved with every conversation. This is not for those that want to live with kind of every kind of way you want to live. But this is for those that say yes to God. And I've got good news. It doesn't matter what happened on yesterday. But if in this moment you say all in, God, your way, all in, I'm all in, all for you. It's all about you. It's all to give you glory. The Father says, don't worry about what happened on yesterday. Don't worry about the delays that took place. He says, because I set you in the right place, in the right momentum, and you are ahead of time. Oh, somebody ought to praise God. Oh, you're getting ready to find out. You're getting ready to see the manifestation of such a huge, ginormous breakthrough that you're going to see that you missed nothing, that all of it was accounted for. All of it was accounted for. It's your set time. Now open up your mouth and give God praise for the favor. His favor has bust the door wide open. Say, favor has given you promotion. Favor has brought increase in your life. Favor has brought new connection. Favor has given you wealth. Favor has brought increase. Favor has enlarged your territory. Just touch three people and say, it's a favor. It's a favor. See, I don't just have favor. I've been mantled with favor. Woo! I'm mantled with favor. Hallelujah. Somebody believes that thing so much. You need to run to that phone and sow a seed. Hallelujah. Dial 1-855-730-WORD. As a matter of fact, sow a seed of $120. That 120 represents, come on, the 120 in the upper room. It was a whole lot more people that was told to be in that room, but they did not follow the instructions. But that 120 was the remnant that obeyed. And you need to say, I'm one of the ones. Hallelujah. That's taking the power of the presence of God into all the worlds, that the gospel would be proclaimed into the entertainment arena. Oh yeah, into the entertainment area, into the areas of medical systems, into the areas of medicine, into the area of the arts. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. In the business arena, in the finance arena. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Hallelujah. Oh, you better know and know that God is awakening that thing that's on the inside of you. You want to go and sow that seed now. Dial 1-855-730-WORD. Or listen, 1-855-730-WORD and plant that seed of $120. Take the gospel around the world. And when you sow this seed into international ground, you can expect an international harvest. Don't think it's strange. Glory be to God when you're sitting up in Africa. Don't think it's strange when you're in another continent and God has given you favor and people are going to begin to ask you things like, how did you get there? And you better not tell no lie about no seven-step program. You better say, God did it. 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 Well, stay tuned. We'll be right back. But I got a special announcement just for you. Put those hands together and give Jesus a great big praise. Hallelujah.
He gonna use the woman of God that can go hood to harbor to Holy Ghost all in 60 seconds. Who am I talking to?
Before anybody knew your name, that's where you and God had that thing going on. And sometimes you need a good pain to push you back to your closet.
The prophetic that's gonna begin to come from your spirit is going to astound and shift a generation.
When you show up, good shows up. When you show up in a bad, confusing situation, tell your neighbor, I am the solution. The church focuses on the problem, but the kingdom goes with the solution.
You have the audacity to believe you can get it back again, that you can get it better than before. Hallelujah, that God will do greater than your past. He's outdoing history. He's outdoing history.
Thank you.
Step in that anointing. Step in that anointing. That healing anointing. That healing anointing. That healing anointing. That healing anointing.
Hallelujah. Give him praise. I want to see you at the Jesus Girl Summit 2019. Well, we have the great Bishop Nelson here with us on tonight. Finally, come on, give God a great big praise for this man of God, the bishop.
So glad.
Getting ready to sing my favorite song.
Really, your favorite? Oh,
one of my favorites. Okay. We wore your song out in our church.
Well, we received.
Yes, and that song will make you think you can sing, even if you can't. Yes, yes. You know the anointing make anything sound good, because it can get you over. But you better know not to show up at the Apollo. Where did that song? You know, you don't want the Sandman to be like, ooh.
Well, we thank God the Lord allows for a joyful noise in the church. So it doesn't necessarily have to be great to sing that song. But Forever really was, the origin of it was with my wife, to be honest.
Wow.
I was in a writing session with my producer, and my wife walked in and interrupted, as she usually does, and started singing, "Forever's a long time, that's how long I love you." And I looked at my producer, he looked at me, we were like, okay, that's something.
Wow.
And about 10 minutes later, the song was written. Like,
wow.
Literally, it just, the Lord poured it out of us. The hardest part about writing a song was trying to figure out who was talking to whom. And once we really unpacked that, a human being can't say to another human being, I'll love you forever, because we don't live that long. Mm-hmm. Only God exists, you know, from forever right. to forever, from eternity to eternity. So once we knew that this was God really speaking to us, and that I'll love you regardless of what's happening, the song kind of just was birthed out of us.
Thank you for that, because again, like your first song that you sang, you're singing songs that express the heart of a worshiper.
Yeah.
And the relationship, the intimate relationship with the Lord. That's not just some religious experience, but one that says, I know him, and he knows us personally. Thank you for that. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Come on, put your hands together for Forever.
So like we just said, this is God talking to us. Is there anybody in the room who knows you've been loved and you will be loved forever? God says, I'll be committed to you. I'll never leave you. Nothing in this world could make me walk away. No matter what life may bring, I'll be by your side. No matter what you face, you won't be lonely. Because forever is a long time. That's how long I love you. That's how long I love you. Forever. God says forever is a long time. That's how long.
Love is
Prophet Cynthia Thompson, along with her husband, former NBA great Billy Thompson from the Los Angeles Lakers and the Miami Heat, serves as the senior pastor of Jesus People Proclaim International Ministries Church in Boca Raton, Florida. Prophet Cynthia Thompson is a triple threat to the kingdom of darkness with her prolific and effective preaching and teaching on the apostolic and prophetic.
I told you, that song make you think you can sing. Woo, where you think about the love of God. Hallelujah. And he'll love us forever. How long? Forever and ever. It's unending. Oh, glory be to God. And you may say, well, I just want God to love me more. He already does. There's nothing you can do to make God love you anymore. He simply already does. Well, our next guest, good God Almighty, we're so thankful that this powerhouse is here. Backed by Holy Ghost demand, with the word of the Lord in her mouth, she's fierce. Yes, she is. She's dainty and dangerous. She's a ladies' lady, but don't you sleep on her. She is somebody that will come in and bring transformation and change. I want you to help me welcome my good friend that I've known for years, none other than Prophet Cynthia Thompson. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. You just returned from
Africa. Dubai. I went to South Africa and to Dubai. It was awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. Awesome trip.
Tell.
Yes. You can tell.
Yes.
No.
I was looking at your pictures.
Yes, I had a great time. Thank you for having me back here with you.
Listen, girl, you came out the gate last time and just, we knew the heavens were open.
Hallelujah.
As soon as you opened up your mouth, there was an outpour. And one of the things that we appreciate about you is that you keep your ear to the mouth of God.
Amen.
And so we just brought you back because we're greedy. We said we want the overflow. And so we want to hear what God has been sharing with you. We're at halftime. And like I was sharing with them earlier, our bishop, Bishop Orange, preached so on Sunday morning. I'm telling you, he preached so I wanted to jump on his back. But I knew probably if I jumped on his back, he probably would have like fell out on the floor and then we wouldn't got the rest of what God wanted to say. But that's how he preached so in this place. And it was so prophetic and so on time. And we just want to hear from you second, as we're going into the second half of the year before we hit 2020, what the Lord is saying, because it's important to be moving in what he's saying. And not just what he said on yesterday, but what is he saying?
Saying right now.
Yes, what is God saying? Yes. And to move in that word and to make sure that we're taking the territories that we're supposed to take or preparing the way that we should. And would you just share with us concerning what God has been giving to you concerning the church?
Okay, well, bless the Lord. It's exciting to be back here. Everybody, oh my God, it's so exciting to be back here. God is doing amazing things.
Yes,
and you know,
is.
One of the things he spoke to me when I was on the plane coming here, you know, because we can just, you know, one of the jokes they have about me is that I can just preach off everything, you know.
Right.
There is a word from the Lord.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? And one of the things the Lord was speaking to me on the plane on my way here, you know, he's been interrupting me. Tell him I said this. Tell him I said that. So there was a specific word to the audience tonight that God sent me here to bring to the people, those that are here and those that are tuning in. And one of the things he said to me is that the people need to understand the appointed time of God. And he said to me, he said, tell my people that they are missing the appointed time.
Come on.
Because we're getting frustrated in the wait.
Mm.
We're getting aggravated. We're losing our sense of direction because we're in the hallways of life.
Come on.
We've left one place and we've not quite entered into the next.
Come on.
And you know, often in the hallway, it gets a little scary because it's dark and you can't often see your way.
Mm-hmm.
But I heard the Lord say a lot of times when we can't trace God, we got to trust God.
That's right.
And trusting God is having a relationship with God.
That's
and
right.
So he said to me, he said, because the people don't understand that I set a time, there's an appointed time for what I put in their lives to come forth. There is an appointed time. You know, a seed cannot come forth before it's time.
Right.
And so the Lord said to me, he said, but tell them there's an appointed time because we need to understand this tonight. We need to understand that when we talk about the prophetic, and I brought my book because I wrote this book on the power of the prophetic mindset.
Come on.
Because people need to know how to set their minds in the prophetic.
Yes.
Because we think the prophetic is just a breeze Pentecostal word that we just hear in the you know, the church doing religious circles. Mm-hmm. And God is saying no, because we don't understand what the prophetic is. And I think when I was here last, I mentioned about the prophetic is a ram that houses the powers. It's the ram that houses all the spiritual weapons. But he said to me, he said it's more than prophecy. Mm-hmm. And so a lot of times people, when they hear the prophetic, they think prophecy. But prophecy is the ministry of seeing and saying. Mm-hmm. And so oftentimes we go on a journey, Dr. Medina, we're looking for a word. Uh-huh. We're going places and saying, if I can just get a word, get a word, get a word. And the Lord is saying to me, he said, tell my people tonight, they got many words. Right. And so what has been in us is that we are loaded with word. But what we don't understand is that when you start now understanding the ministry of the prophetic, the ministry of the prophetic, it gives us spiritual interpretation. And so what it does, it brings activation. And so not only does it activate, it brings acceleration. And so what we are missing now, and I heard you said it earlier, I said, I know you sent me tonight, and I'm on course. On. Because what God said to me, he says, the people are loaded with word, but they won't release the spirit. Mm. And he said to me, what's in the seed when you put a seed in the ground? He says, what goes into the seed? Everything is in the seed. The potential, the purpose, come on, the destiny. It is in the seed. And God said, I've given my people word, and I've given them the word, and they're running after the word, and they have confessed the word. But what they won't do is go into the ground, even if some that are in the ground. He said, what they won't do is die. He says, because until the seed die, what's in the seed can't come forth. And what's in the seed is great harvest. Because we're in a great season of harvest and gain. We're in a season that we don't understand that it's an appointed time for what God put in us to be birthed and manifest. So 2019 was the year God began to declare. Now listen to this. I'm going to run through this quick. Because 2017 was the year of severing and separation. And he begins to say, I'm cutting away the things in our lives. And so we had to tell people bye. We had to get rid of stuff, you know. And it was so serious in what God was saying. He said, I'm cutting it. And so the sevens line up. It was cut. God was so serious, it was a three-way cutting. And so he said, it's irreversible. So that means that what he cut can't return. And then he brought us in 2018, and he said, I'm bringing you into new beginnings, because I had to cut away the old to set you in a place for something new. And so what we've not been able to really, really understand is that this ain't what it was. This is a new place. And what we do sometimes when we don't have proper discernment, because we don't understand the prophetic dimensions that have been given to us to cause what is in us to come alive, what we do sometimes is that we find ourselves misinterpreting our season. We find ourselves getting right when you're at the breaking of your greatest moment, we walk away. People are leaving and walking away, jumping ship, because they're not discerning the times and the seasons like the sons of Issachar. And they begin to look out and discern the times and the season. And he said they're jumping ship because some of them don't understand what I put in them was set for an appointed time. And we are in an appointed time for things to come forth. So he said it's a season of newness. Somebody need to say newness. Newness, meaning what you've seen before, you ain't seeing in this season. He's saying it's so new. Come on. You're going to have to reintroduce yourself to yourself. God is saying this was coming forth in this season is so anointed, so powerful. He's saying, I'm telling you, if I had told you before time, you would have killed it. Why? Because this man named Apostle Paul, when God was getting ready to do something new, the Bible says Paul was going about killing everything because he didn't interpret properly what God had been in. Sometimes we're in seasons in our lives. Y'all know what I'm talking about? We can be in a season of now and we'll kill everything in our now, not knowing that we need some of it for our next. And what we've been doing is misinterpreting. And so he said to me, as we came into new beginnings, he said, you can't take what's old into the new. So it will require you to change. And so when we came into 2019, God began to declare. He said, I'm telling you, not only did you sever some things to kill it, so you can't go back to your past. Come on. That man can't call you. You can't get caught up in none of that mess no more. He said, I sever it. He says that I'm bringing you into a new place. But when we don't understand newness, we'll go back to old.
Come on,
we'll go back to old. And God is saying, but you can't go. He separated it so there's a gulf. And so now we're in this year of 219, and he said 219 was about giving birth. And so he says 219 is about the seed that I put in your life for the appointed time for what I call you to do to come forth. And so we've been waiting to get into this place of 219 because 220 is going to be amazing. Because when we come to 219, he says, now I want you to bear down and push. Why? Because I've been taking you through a process of death. I've been causing you to kill everything in you that that's trying to abort what you're carrying. I've been causing you to die to everything in your belly. Come on. Things that's been trying to wrap itself around your umbilical cord. You're not hearing me. There are some things that's been trying to choke out destiny and purpose. And God said, I had to get you to an appointed time because what's in your belly has to come forth now. What God has given you, every dream, I'm telling you, we're in one of the most pregnant, potent seasons of our time. Heaven is ready to release. There is a prophetic release even in here tonight. God said, I sent the prophets because I did not finish. I was gathering them to know that even on tonight, I'm going to release what's been in your belly. There's got an anointing in here tonight. God said, the winds are blowing and it's blowing in your favor. He said, I'm telling you, this is your now season. This is the time that I was setting you up for. Why? Because by the time you push out this baby in 2019, when you come to 2020, you're going to have a visible, y'all not hearing me, a tangible manifestation. Yes. You're not robo satataya. Yes. You're going to be able to hold your baby in your hands. Why? Because 2020 is about vision. Yes. Everybody's going to see clearly what you've been going through, what you was carrying in your womb, what the travailing was about, what it was God was doing on the inside of you. 2020 would be the year that you would, God would display you on a billboard and show everybody why you had to stay committed, stay in church, kept tithing, kept fasting. Come on, y'all, keep praying. Why? Because the prophetic dimensions are open. The heavens are speaking. And I heard the like, Rabasata. Somebody need to say glory. Somebody say, this is my appointed time. It couldn't have happened last year. It couldn't have happened. Y'all not hearing me. It couldn't have happened 2 years ago. But you have come into an appointed time. And God say, this now was about that. And what that was is getting ready to bear witness for what it was you was warring with.
Thank you,
as a matter of fact, he says, when a seed go into the ground, that seed's purpose is that it begins to make a demand. Now, the thing about the seed has to yield itself to the soil. The seed has to just sit there and say, I yield myself for what's in me to come out. And God is setting the soil of your life. He's been trying to cultivate you in worship. And we find ourselves when we come into seasons of newness. We're trying to bring that old worship. And God is saying that old worship won't set a soil for what's in your belly. That old worship won't set the soil and wiping what you got to bring forth in this season. He's been preparing the soil in your life. And he's been saying, don't sing that song. Sing this. Come on, y'all not hearing me. He's been saying, I want you to talk to me like this. Come on. Remind me of what I said. Speak my word. Attract me back into the room with you. And God has been saying, call me back in on the issue. And so we're finding ourselves in this season where God is saying, I've been preparing the soil of your life because what's going in the ground. Somebody say, I'm not going to lose this year. Say, my baby's coming forth. I decree and declare your vision. I decree and declare your purpose. I decree and I prophesy tonight in this atmosphere. There is something about the prophetic dimensions that begin to stir the waters in your womb. I prophesy to the waters in your womb that what you've been carrying, it comes forth in this season. And Prophet Medina, I know you talked about the 120, and I heard the Lord say, even as I was coming up here, and I feel the anointing now. I'm telling you, I don't know where you are, where you're listening, where you are tonight, but I want you to hear me prophetically. 120, I heard you say 120 represented the men in the upper room, and the Lord began to speak to me. Oh my God, he told me about the appointed times on the plane. And so he began to speak to me. He said, tell them 120 symbolizes an appointed time. Hallelujah. I thought, God, you're blowing my mind because we're so connected in the spirit. Because you're talking about the releasing of the spirit that is about to bring forth what's been in you. Not just the word, but you got to kiss the spirit back to the word. There has to be a marrying of the word and the spirit. Because inside the seed, it holds light. And you need water and light to bring forth. But God put everything in the seed. He put the water and the word. Y'all not hearing me. And then he set the glory in it. Y'all not hearing me. And the glory began to breathe on your seed. So he's saying, I need you to get back in my presence in this season. I'm wiping in the soil of worship. Come back into the secret place. Because this is your season to bring forth. And the Lord say, 120, 120, where you're listening, where you can hear me. You need to go and just begin to sow a seed. Because I'm telling you, something prophetically is stirring in here tonight. And God is saying, it's an anointing on the 120.
Oh, yes, it is.
It's an anointing. Why? Because it's a set and appointed time. Because if you look it up, 120 symbolizes. That's why he told them to wait.
Yes.
They had to wait for the anointing. They had to wait to be endowed with the Spirit. He says, why? Because some of us are running empty. Some of us are trying to tell people what God said, and we don't have the release of the Spirit. Come on. You got to be endowed. You got to have something on you that drips off you like Peter. You don't need to sit in God just to get a word for yourself, but you need an anointing that when people come in your presence, they get healed. When people come in your presence, they begin to repent. You're not hearing me. When people come in your presence, they begin to see, what must I do to be saved? There is still a glory, and the Bible says the latter glory shall be greater than the former. So I want to tell you, I know my time is up, but I want to say this. Please hear me where you're standing in here tonight. God is blowing winds. There is something when you get dry. God knows when to send the rain. God's got the perfect time for a release. Woo, somebody say release. He knows when you are just at your right moment of being just dry. Oh my God, the precipitation begin to rise.
Yes.
And the clouds begin to become thick with water. You're not hearing me. And when the clouds get thick with water, come on, there is a release.
Thank you, Jesus.
And the heavens are pregnant. And the rain is about to fall. Because you're in your appointed time to bring forth what is in your belly. Don't let your baby die. Don't let your dream stay on the shelf. God say, tell me, I got too much potential out here and purpose, and the earth is moaning and groaning. Come on, waiting for you to come forth. And this is your coming forth, coming out, bearing forth.
Come on.
With what God is putting you, I decree and declare by 2020.
Thank you, Jesus.
I decree and declare over this place that everybody's going to bear witness. They thought they was playing when they said the Messiah was coming. And they kept saying, the Messiah is coming, the Messiah is coming. The people say, yeah. You've been telling people you're going to write your book. You've been telling people you're going to start your business. You've been telling people your ministry getting ready to go to the next level. You've been speaking out of your mouth and just saying what God has been speaking to you. But I want you to know, every woman and child, son, daughter, whoever's listening to me at the sound of my voice, I release a prophetic anointing. I'm a prophet of the Lord. I'm not a gift. I'm an officer. So we bear the rams of the prophetic. We don't just come to talk about it. We come to bring you into divine expression. We come to cause you to enter into a place you've never gone tonight. So I decree and declare, as you begin to make out your seed, go on, call that number on that line. You guys in here tonight, I'm telling you, the Lord said the 120 is an appointed. It's a symbolism of an appointed. Somebody say appointed time. Say, this is my set time of favor. This is my set season for what's in me to come forth. Say 2020, everybody's going to see clearly who I am and what God has called me to do. Now put your hands together and give God some praise.
It's for an appointed time.
It's for an appointed time.
Glory be to God.
And we get frustrated. It can't come before time.
And it couldn't happen before because it wasn't a set time.
It wasn't a set
time. So whatever didn't work before, it wasn't the timing for it to work.
Jesus.
Whatever failed before, come on here, it wasn't even a failure. It was a lesson to prepare you for the real deal.
Woo!
But then you said this is not only in word. So this appointment that the people of God has stepped into, it is an appointment that is ushering in the power into different sectors around the world. It's like Paul said, listen, we didn't come to you in word only, but in power. And we came in power and in demonstration. There's a lot of people coming in word, but no power. Word and no presence. God is saying, how? I'm sending you. I'm sending you in my presence.
My
undeniable presence. My presence so strong on your life that businessmen would bow and ask, what must I do? What can I do to be saved in the boardroom? See, God's presence on you, causing you to think in such a place where you're thinking like God. You're seeing like God. God giving you super intelligence. God giving you information. God sharing secrets with you. It won't just be some words. Paul said, listen, I didn't just bring words to you, because the people he was speaking to were some of the best speakers in the world. So if I just brought words, that was nothing to compete with them. He said, if I did that, then I would bankrupt the cross. I'm not trying to bankrupt the cross. I'm trying to present the power of the cross. And so God is using his people to infiltrate sectors around the world to present the power of the cross. Not how good we look, not how smart we are, but what God's power can do. He's setting you on a hill. He's setting you on the top. He's setting you as a city on a hill that cannot be hid, so that the power of the cross can be displayed. Woman of God, you got my baby leaping.
And you know what? Can I just say this and close out on this? The prophetic realm is the realm of power. And so while you're looking for just a mere word, you should be tapping into a realm. Because it's no longer set aside just for a few. It is made available for every one of you. And it is time for us to step into the dimension of power.
Yes.
That place is what activates and ignites. So when you are speaking, it sets you apart. If that is not, if the case is that we never step into it, then what was the purpose of the cross?
Come on.
The purpose of the cross was to bring you into a resurrected life.
Yes.
A life of power. A life that caused people to see that the realness of God is upon you.
Yes.
And I'm telling you, we're in that season where we have gone with the word. We've getting more educated.
Come on.
We're finding ourselves getting greater degrees.
Come on.
But we're losing the power.
Come on.
And there was a generation waiting for us to demonstrate the realness of God. And it comes out of the prophetic realms.
Yes.
Because it houses every power.
Yes.
Every power that we operate in is in that realm.
This next generation needs to see the God that
will
allow a drunk man to come in drunk and walk out sober because of the power.
They got to see it.
Words don't transform somebody's life. It's the power of the Holy Ghost. It is only the penetrating power of the Holy Ghost that would cause sinners to be convicted to say, I need to be saved.
Come on.
And so that's why we can't just go in somebody's message you saw on Facebook, but we got to go in the fact that we sat in the presence of God and the fact that God lives on the inside of us, the overflowing power of God, that even before we open up our mouths, come on, you know how people would say to you, there's something about you. You didn't even say anything, but it's the glow, it's the glory, it's the presence. Oh, glory be to God. You're going to walk into areas and areas are going to shift because of God's presence on you. I'm excited about this time. I'm excited about the move of God. Are you excited about the move of God? Somebody thank God for Prophet Cynthia Thompson.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Woo. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God.
I'm telling you.
He gonna use the woman of God that can go hood to harbor to Holy Ghost all in 60 seconds. Who am I talking to?
Before anybody knew your name, that's where you and God had that thing going on. And sometimes you need a good pain to push you back to your closet.
The prophetic that's gonna begin to come from your spirit is going to astound and shift a generation.
When you show up, good shows up. When you show up in a bad, confusing situation, tell your neighbor, I am the solution. The church focuses on the problem, but the kingdom goes with the solution.
You have the audacity to believe you can get it back again, that you can get it better than before. Hallelujah, that God will do greater than your past. He's outdoing history. He's outdoing history.
Jesus Girl Summit 2019, I want to see you there. It's happening. It's happening in Richmond, Virginia. We're going to have an amazing time. It's always, seriously, it's always like this, a mountaintop getaway with God. And I love it because there's a whole bunch of God chasers, people that just want the presence of God over everything. I'm telling you, we have people that cry at the end of the summit because it's over and they don't want to go home, but they got to get up out of there. So you want to meet us in Richmond, Virginia. I'm serious about it. No joke. Listen, we have still with us the mighty man of God, Bishop Jason Nelson, singing, I Am.
Stand does impossible things. That's who I am. Just let me be who I am to you. That's who I am. Just let me be who I am for you. I'm the one who sees your need and always provides. I am the one whose name is a tower where you can run and hide. I am he who has all power in my hands. And if you believe on my word, you can stand. 'Cause I am healer, mender. He says,
that song. I know you do. That's right. Go on and download it. Glory be to God. These songs are oily. I tell you, they just take you right on in. They take you right on in. These are throne room songs. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Put your hands together and thank God for Bishop Nelson at this time. Well, our next guest, she's another powerhouse. I love her spirit, and I tell you what I really love about her, not just that she can preach and that she's a prophetess and that God uses her, but I love her humility. You know, sometimes people can be a little extra. You haven't met anybody like that, right? No, the extra folks, you know, like, I have arrived. This woman of God, her humility, her kindness, just being friendly, just spoke volumes to me when we met. And the way God uses her, it's like the whole room just turns upside down, inside out, and things are just set straight. I want you to help me welcome none other than Prophetess Linda Roark. Thank you for being here with us.
Thank you, woman of God. It's such an honor.
I meant exactly what I said. You are so kind.
Thank you. And so are you. I love your spirit. And I just thank God. I said, I don't even know how I've got here to sit in your presence. You're just an awesome woman of God. Your integrity, your character speaks for itself. Just by watching you from afar before I ever met you, it's amazing how God, when you have that kingdom connection, yeah. You thought, I just love her. She don't even know me, but I just love her. But oh, I love I your spirit. Love you. You're so beautiful.
Thank you, Papa. You brought your daughters
He's
together.
He's so good to us. That's why I call him Papa, Abba.
You call him Papa, too?
I do call him Papa. I call him Papa. I call him Abba.
Yeah.
I just love the Lord so much.
I have written in my closet, on the wall, you're the best dad ever.
Yes, he is.
I said, boy, somebody come up in his closet. Well, who's she talking about?
Oh,
but, you get it.
I get it.
You get it,
I get it.
We're so happy that you are back here with us. You've been preaching somewhere everywhere.
Yes.
How long have you been in ministry?
22 years.
22 years. Yes. Wow. Yes. Come on.
Been plowing through and digging and been seeing God do amazing things. We've seen healing, deliverances. We see a lot of deliverance in this ministry, and that's my heart. That's my passion. I had a sister that died at the age of 42 because of drug substance. And I made a vow to God. I said, God, send every broken woman to me.
Mm.
And when we go around
the world.
Say
that again. See, that's some fear stuff right there. See, that's some real preacher stuff right there.
Yes, yes, yes. I said, Lord, bring the broken women to me. And I made a vow to God. I said, God, I will do everything within me that you have placed within me, that anointing, because Isaiah 10 and 27 said, it shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be lifted off your shoulder and the yoke from off of your neck.
Yes.
The anointing is the only thing that will destroy yokes.
Yes.
And that's what God spoke to me. I recently preached that. I was talking about Philip, how God used one man to go down to the city of Samaria and preach the gospel until the witch believed. We got to preach until the witch believes in our neighborhood. Come on, somebody. And it's going to take the anointing that was in Peter's in his shadow and Paul's clothes, and it's coming back. There is a major shift,
woman of God,
in the earth realm. God is raising up these prophetic voices and releasing a prophetic word, because it reminded me of Ezekiel when I was praying and seeking God and fasting about this program. And I know it's prophetic rain. We talked about Elijah, the abundance of rain, but the Lord took me to Ezekiel. When he told Ezekiel, he said, can these bones live? Can these bones live? And he said, oh God, thou knowest if these bones can live. And he said, prophesy to these dry bones, my God. And he said, he began to prophesy. And when he began to prophesy, the Bible said, bone came to his bone. Come on. Hallelujah. I don't want to get ahead of myself. But bone came to his bone. And the Bible said, now he said, son of man, prophesy to the wind of God. He said, prophesy to the four winds. And he began to prophesy, oh breath, the ruach of God, the breath of God. And the Bible said that when he began to prophesy to the wind, that the wind, the breath, the ruach, the spirit of God resuscitated them dead things. My God. And the Bible said that they stood up an exceedingly great army, woman of God. Hallelujah. And God said this to me. He said, whatever's been dead in this season or whatever has looked dead, don't bury it, because I'm getting ready to resurrect it. God said, whatever has lied dormant is getting ready to stand up again. Because the Bible said that the dry bones, they stood up onto their feet, an exceedingly great army. And God said something so powerful to me, woman of God. He said, there is a wind, a prophetic wind that is getting ready to blow in the earth. It took me back to Exodus when God delivered the children of Israel out of Egypt, brought them all the way down to Baal-zephon. He brought them down to a dead-end situation. Yes, he did. Hallelujah. And they looked behind them, and God said, this is a season that you cannot look behind you. He said, Moses, tell them to go forth and stop their crying. Good God of Zion.
That's a word right,
that's
there.
A word right there. People's murmuring and complaining so much, that's why they're stuck, woman of God. But he said, I want you, Moses, to stretch out your hand. Hand represents authority, and it represents power, woman of God. With the rod in your hand, stretch it out. And the Bible said that the Lord caused a strong east wind to blow all that night. And God said to me, he said, woman of God, he said, I'm getting ready to cause a wind to blow in this season, because the east wind means the forefront, or in the front of, or to anticipate. And God said, what I'm getting ready to do, I'm getting ready to go in before you, and the things that try to block you out is getting ready to take you in. Hallelujah. The Bible said a strong east wind blew all that that night. See, the stronger the wind, higher the wave.
Yeah.
Woo, good God of Zion. Yes. Hallelujah. And I believe this is a season that God is shifting things in the earth, and he's using prophetic voices, because he said in the word in Amos, he said, I won't do nothing but reveal my secrets to my prophets. And God is raising up prophets, and he's releasing a sound in the earth, woman of God, because in this hour, we need the sound.
Yes.
We need to release the anointing.
Yes.
The anointing has to come back.
Yes.
To see the true manifestation of the power of God. That I'm old school. I was raised old school, Pentecost, amen. Uh-huh. And we seen demons cast out in the church. They didn't take them out into a little conference room and say, let's cast the demon out over there. But no, God said, this is the hour that we as prophetic voices stand up and not be afraid and declare what thus saith the Lord.
Come
because
on,
God said, I am getting ready to release a sound in the earth, and I'm getting ready to cause a prophetic wind to blow away the debris. The thing that had you blocked out will now take you over. Somebody, you better praise God. You that are watching by way of TV, God said, you've been in your Egypt long enough. I've heard your cry, and your deliverance is coming. You better praise him in your living room, and you better thank him for your prophetic shift. Wave after wave, an overflowing, a wave of God's favor, a prophetic wind. God said, it's about to hit your house. It's about to hit your children. It's about to hit your finances. And God said, when it does, I'm going to resurrect everything. Oh, he said, I'm going to resurrect every dead thing that is lying dormant. God said, prophesy. Open up your mouth and prophesy. Prophesy to your drug addict children. Prophesy to your bank account. Open up your mouth and say it like you mean it.
Hallelujah.
Oh, there comes a wind. Oh, I prophesy to the wind of God, the Spirit of God. I speak in your home. I speak to Africa. I speak to Nigeria. I command every demon spirit, every witchcraft spirit that has held you bound. I break every generational curse in the name of Jesus. I come against that Leviathan spirit. I decree and I declare right now, who the Son sets free is free indeed. God said, prophesy. Open up your mouth. You want to change what you're reaping. You got to change what you're speaking. Open up your mouth and say, God, I thank you on tonight that my season is shifting.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Open up your mouth.
Oh, I feel healing in this place. I sense deliverance, woman of God. God said, I want to deliver somebody in the studio today. Oh, my God. I prophesy, come on. There's a wind, that causes a resurrection. The resurrection power of God, woman of God. God said, we got to open up our mouth as prophetic voices and start decreeing and declaring it. Come on. Give him some praise. Whatever's been holding you back is getting ready to break. Whatever looked like a loss is actually a gain. I said, whatever looks like a loss is actually a gain. God said, I'm getting ready to bring back a restitution. I'm getting ready to restore to you the years that the locust has eaten, the cankerworm and the pummelworm. That God said that I'm getting ready to do it. I'm getting ready to work it in your favor. God said, I'm getting ready to work it in your favor. Oh, shut up. You better praise him right there. You better praise him like you know he's going to do it.
Thank you.
We need the real Holy Ghost and fire. We need old school. Come on. We need an old school. Come on. We need a flashback tonight. Come on, somebody. Lay your hands on your head and say, God, I thank you. You're shifting it for me tonight. My God. I heard the Holy Spirit say, I just heard a word of knowledge. God said, I'm healing your blood pressure. Wave your hand at me. Come here. Is this okay, woman of God? Yes, I'm going to get it. Come here. Come on. Hallelujah. God said, I'm going to heal your blood pressure. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. God said, somebody right in this section right here. Hallelujah. Come on. There's acid reflex. You suffer from an acid reflex disease. God said, I'm going to heal it. If you come up here and believe God, come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah. Lord, I speak to your blood. I speak to your blood right now, and I command it to regulate. I speak the healing power of Jesus. I prophesy to the wind, the rock of God. Breathe out. Be healed in Jesus' name. Come on, you better praise him. You better praise him. You better praise him. You better thank him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You better move when the Holy Spirit says move. The Bible said, woman of God, when the bones came together, there was a shaking. With a shaking, there comes a sound. See, when the Lord told Joshua, he said, the Lord instructed Joshua, he told him to march around the wall.
Yes, yes.
But Joshua said, what time that you hear the sound, all the people shall shout.
Come on.
The word shout means an acclamation, a joy, or to rejoice. In other words, they were to put a praise on that wall.
Yes.
And the praise was so powerful, woman of God, that it caused a wall to crumble.
Come on.
And within the next 10 seconds, as I'm getting ready to get out of the way, I have to respect the time. God said within the next 10 seconds, as they raised the sound up, God said that you release a sound. There's a sound in your belly.
Come on.
That's going to cause a shifting in your home before you get home. It's going to cause a shifting in your finances before you come on Monday morning. God said, I'm going to give you a raise. My God, I thank you, Jesus. Woman of God, God spoke this to me. I want to tell him this. God said this to me. He said, Linda, he said, I'm getting ready to do something bigger than your vision.
Come on.
I'm getting ready to do something bigger than your vision. You've not even thought about this, but do you have enough strength to stand under it?
My God.
Woman of God, I would have never would imagine. I've seen myself do amazing things. God has shown me great visions, traveling around the world, preaching the gospel. But I would have never had imagined for this kingdom connection, and I don't take it lightly, that God is strategically moving and placing things in alignment.
Yes.
And there's some of you in this studio tonight, and you are watching by way of TV tonight.
Yes.
God is strategically shifting and moving things in your favor.
Yes.
And God said, I'm getting ready to do something bigger than your vision. Your eyes haven't seen. Your ears haven't heard. It's not even entered into your heart. God said, you not even asked for this. But he said, you just watch me. Because the Bible says in Exodus, when the east wind began to blow, God gave him a 24-hour turnaround. And God said, if you will believe it as you release the sound out of your belly, God said, I'm giving somebody a 24-hour turnaround. Are you ready?
Hallelujah.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yeah.
Release! 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 Release for your children! Release for your healing! Release for your breakthrough! Here it comes! Wave after wave! The stronger the wind, the bigger the wave! You need to give God a praise!
Hallelujah!
Woo! The wind is shifting it in your favor tonight! Woman of God, there's a prophetic wind in this studio tonight. Oh, you better praise him like you know he already shifted. Good God of Zion.
Hallelujah.
You better thank him.
tonight. I speak right now to that glaucoma. I speak to that cancer. I command it to cough up in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare your heart is healed. Come on, praise it for the next 30 seconds. Say to God, I'm telling you, God said, when you open up your mouth, every time you open up your mouth, the rock of God, the breath of God, the spirit of God is flowing out of your belly. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Whatever's held you back, I heard the Holy Ghost say that it just broke. Whatever's held you back, just broke. I said, whatever's held you back, that failed marriage has just been healed. Whatever's held you back, that children on drugs has just been delivered. You better thank God that the anointing of God destroys every yoke.
It just broke. 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 You better praise him. 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 Praise him in your home. Praise him in your kitchen. Praise him in your bedroom. Praise him in the studio. Break out in an uncommon praise.
Come on.
Break out and give him glory.
Yay.
Break out and give him honor. Break out and shout unto him.
Yay.
Break out and dance in
yes.
his presence. Leap in his presence.
Yes.
Shout in his presence.
Yes.
Woo! There's another way. There's another way.
Yay.
There's another way.
Yay.
And it's hitting your house. There's
yes.
another way.
The way of God's faith.
Woo! Woo! Oh,
yes, yes, yes.
Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Hey! I feel like praising him.
Yes.
I feel like giving him glory. Everything's changed. Woman of God. While you're praising him, you need to run and sow that seed. As you know, here we don't play no game. At Medina Pullins Live, we're not pulling no rabbits out of hat. We're working the principles of God. Hallelujah. Pick up that phone and dial 1-855-730-WORD. And take the word of God, the presence of God, the move of God around the world. Hallelujah. Somebody needs to jump. Somebody need to leap. Somebody need to run. Somebody need to dance. Because everything has shifted. Everything has changed. While you were praising him, a divine release hit your house. While you were praising him, God has settled that thing that was unsettled. While you were praising, oh, glory be to God. God has shifted it in your favor. While you were praising, God has set your name on the king's heart. You better give God the glory in this place. My God. Woman of God, you're my kind of girl. Woo. Thank you, Jesus. Let's give it up and thank God for Prophetess Linda. Come on. Woo. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to praise him. Because you're not going without the power. Every messenger so far has been talking about the presence of God. That
you're dealing with valley situations, God is sending you in as a specialist. And how are you at a specialist? You're the glory carrier. You're the glory carrier. In comes the glory carrier. In comes somebody that's been sitting in his presence. In comes somebody that's cascading with the presence of God. Here comes the glory carrier. Where the bound cannot stay bound. Oh, yeah. Where the dumb cannot stay mute. Oh, you're the deaf cannot stay deaf. Here comes the glory carrier. Carrying in the presence of God. Transporting in the presence of God. Well, this song is the right song. We have coming right now. He's been here with us all night. The man of God has been here. Bishop Jason Nelson, look at here, in the room. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
I can hear the Lord. Saying I'm aware, and I've heard your prayer, and no matter how you feel, just know that I am still in control. Know that I am here, and whatever in the room, I can hear the Lord saying that I'm aware, and I've heard your prayer, and no matter how you feel, just know that I am still in control. God says, whatever you need, whatever you need, whatever you need, it's in this room. Whatever you need, ooh, whatever you need, whatever. It's whatever you need,
whatever you need,
whatever you need,
whatever you need.
Anybody believe that? It's in the room.
It's in the room.
Just receive it. Whatever you need,
whatever you need.
See, the Lord is here, and whatever,
whatever you need,
whatever. Right now, can I tell you what's here? Your healing is here, and your breakthrough is here, and your joy is here, and it's in the room right now. Somebody just lift your hands and receive, because you're
here.
It's in the room right now.
It's in the
this room.
Whatever you need is in the room. And you can get his music wherever music is sold. I know you want to run and get a copy of it. MP Live, we have the great pleasure of having the woman of God back here with us. She's not in Africa tonight, but I guess she is beaming there around the world right now. We are graced with her presence, none other than Pastor Jenny Hart. Come on, let's praise God. For Jenny Hart.
Hello, Dr. Medina. How are you?
I'm blessed to have you back here with us.
Thank you. Thank you. Wow, what a night. God is present.
What
Do you
night.
Feel the presence of the Lord in the place tonight?
Yes.
Wow, such a powerful, powerful night. God has already been speaking
yes.
prophetically in
yes.
this place. There is a word for you tonight, and if you haven't heard it yet, it's on the way. It is on the way. God is so amazing. We love you. Can we just give some love, show some love to Dr. Medina Pullings, an amazing woman, powerful woman of God tonight. We love you.
You remind me of a book Erica Campbell has been pushing, her book that's coming out, and I can't wait to get a copy of it. It's called More Than Pretty. Well, tonight, everybody's been really centering in and honing in on what's really important, and that is going into whatever our assignment is with the presence of God,
yes.
with the power
yes.
of God, and that's what you remind me of. You know, you look at you, you're like, oh, look at this pretty lady, but more than pretty. Oh, come on here. Come on, come on, come on. A woman that casts out devils. A woman, yeah. come on here, that will yeah. speak a word of life where a word of life is needed. A word in a woman of God that brings resuscitation, like the woman of God said earlier. We just praise God for you. You were here last time, and you said something. You said people get their get their role and their purpose mixed up, mm-hmm. and I mm-hmm. thought that was so key that you know, oh well, I'm a mother, I'm a this, I'm a that, but they get that and their purpose mixed up. And I want you to come back here and elaborate on that some more about your purpose in life, because that's what we want. We want to live our purpose. What is it that God has placed us on this planet to do?
Exactly. You know, it's really important that you understand what your purpose is. Your purpose and your title are two different things. And a lot of times we get caught up in our title. But I believe that there is a people sitting in the pews that are no longer impressed with titles in the pulpit.
Come on.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. We want some purpose. We want some authority. We want some anointing. We want some move of God. Keep your title. Okay? Because your title is only going to take you so far.
Wow.
Your purpose will take you where your title never could. So your purpose is the reason that God made you, the reason that you exist. Your title is something that is put on you. We talked about Jesus when he went before Pilate. And Pilate called him the king. And he said, yes, you say well, that's what you call me. He said, but for this purpose, I was born. Can I tell you tonight that before you were born, there was purpose on your life? As a matter of fact, it's in your DNA, your purpose. It is so a part of you that you cannot disconnect from it, no matter how hard you try. You see, we talked about that my title will change. At one time, you may be a mother. At one time, you may be married, and then you may be divorced. At one time, you may be a pastor, and now you are no longer functioning in that role. But that does not change your purpose. Your purpose always supersedes your title. You see, in the Old Testament, it says that the Spirit of the Lord came upon David to do a thing. The Spirit of the Lord came upon Samson to what? Do a thing. But then in the book of Acts,
yes.
the 120, it said, now the Spirit of the Lord is in you to do a thing.
Yes.
And that is the explanation between your title and your purpose. You see, your title is in you, but your purpose, your title is on you, but your purpose is in you.
Come on.
And so as they gather, they realize that they had greater purpose than their titles. And so I want you to know tonight, the word that the Lord spoke to me when I was on the way here tonight was this. The Lord said that tell my people that I need them to fiercely focus forward.
Come on.
He needs you to fiercely, with tenacity, with fire, with anointing, to focus forward in this season. You see, we're in a time where men and women of God are being distracted like never before. There are things going on all around you that are trying to take you off focus. Why? Because you are full of destiny, because you are full of purpose. And the enemy's not scared of your title, but he is scared of your purpose.
Yes, he is. Come on.
I'm trying to help you today to realize that in this season, focus is of the utmost importance in your life. As a matter of fact, I believe that there is such greatness in you, that there is such anointing on your life, that God has a plan for you that is bigger than you could even imagine. And if you will begin to paint a prophetic portrait with your words about where you are going and what you are doing and what your purpose is, you will begin to speak that thing if you keep it painted in your spirit, and you will begin to say, I might not look like that now, I might not be there now, but I have a prophetic portrait that is painted with my purpose, and I am running towards that thing, and no weapon formed against me is going to be able to stop that from coming to pass. The woman of God was talking about the valley of the dry bones, and I love it because it's one of my favorite parts, and she talked about bone coming to bone. Let me tell you how that relates to purpose, woman of God, is this, is that it says bone in the King James found his bone. So here you have to see this. You have a valley with soldiers who were fighting, and a soldier probably had his hand cut off about a quarter of a mile that way. But then he kept running because he is a fighter, because he didn't give up, and his body gave out over here. But the Bible says that when the prophet came and he began to speak about the prophetic portrait that God had showed him, that hand over there was purposed to be with this man over here. And so that hand had to get up and go find the right hand, had to go find the right arm. That foot over there, because it was purposed to be with that man, had to go across.
Come on now. You are preaching up in here.
Whatever is purpose for your life, if you will begin to prophesy, if you will begin to speak to that thing, wherever, whatever you need, wherever it is in the world, it is getting up in this season. And it is running towards you. And it is going to find you. I said it's going to find you. Money is going to find you. Health is going to find you. Ministry is going to find you. Your spouse is going to find you. Oh, that should have made somebody shout right there. Because you've been crying on your bed about being alone. God said begin to speak to your purpose. And what you need will find you.
Yes, woman of God. God is using you up in here. Come on. They're a little quiet, but let me tell you something. The thing, you gave instruction. You gave instruction beyond even this night to fiercely, come on, to fiercely focus forward. Now, here it is. Nobody's going to be able to take the prophets that are here tonight and stick you in the pocketbook and bring you at home to prophesy to them tomorrow morning when they're dealing with everyday life. So it's going to take fiercely focusing forward to retain what it is that God has spoken and prophesy to yourself. Take the word that God has spoken to you, meditate on that word, speak that word to yourself, paint a portrait, like you said, on the canvas of your imagination so that that picture will drive you forward. Now, what you just said to me, I believe I heard you say that when you prophesy and when you speak what God has spoken and what God has revealed to you and begin to speak to those things, things are going to come together and it won't go to the wrong parts. It won't go to the wrong places, but the right stuff is going to connect. The right pieces are going to come together. Somebody needs to shout in this place because the right pieces are coming together. Thank you, Jesus. Let them use
you. Is going to find you.
I feel that thing.
Everything designed for you is going to find you. Everything designed for this house is going to find it. Everything designed for your children is going to find them. You don't have to go find it. You don't have to go seeking after it. You begin to speak the thing that God has showed you, and you begin to declare that as God has said it, it is so. Listen, I am telling you tonight that your purpose will put your name in rooms your feet haven't stepped into yet. I said your purpose will put your name in rooms your feet have not yet stepped in. I want you to know tonight that because you are full of purpose, there are people talking about you in boardrooms. There are people talking about you at banks. There are people talking about you who are ready to hire people. They don't even know you. They don't even know what you're doing right now. But God said that because you are full of purpose, everything I have for you is going to find you in this season. Oh, you ought to praise God. You ought to praise God about that. Because some of y'all been looking for some things. Some of y'all been believing for some things. But God said, just rejoice.
Thank you, Jesus.
Just give me praise.
Hallelujah.
Just give me praise.
Thank you.
Praise Him when it looks right. Praise Him when it don't look right. Praise Him when you see it.
Yes.
Praise Him when you don't see it. No matter the situation, if you will keep praising God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Your purpose will be fulfilled. Now listen, here's something I learned, doctor. Is that when I see somebody fulfilling purpose, it is then my job to connect to that. If I want my purpose fulfilled, then I connect with somebody who is doing what I want to do. I connect with somebody who is next level. There are some of you watching tonight that you have been praying, God, what is my purpose? What am I supposed to do? God, what do you have for me? And here you sit looking at a woman of God who knows her purpose, who is living her purpose, who is sowing into the nations. And I want to challenge you tonight, wherever you are, to go to your phone right now and sow into purpose, sow into the nations. Because when you sow into somebody that is what you want to do, that is going where you want to go, God is going to make a way. Now, how do I know that is true? How do I know that is true? Because before I went to South Africa, I found somebody that was there doing what I wanted to do.
My God.
And I sowed a seed, and I didn't know that I was going to be going, but I sowed a seed and said, God bless them in what they're doing. Let me tell you that in less than 6 months, I was living in South Africa, preaching the gospel, seeing people be delivered, set free, healed by the power of God. God will take you, and He will take your seed, and He will cause purpose to manifest.
Yes. I receive it, woman of God.
If you believe that tonight, lift your hands in this room right now and say, in the name of Jesus,
I sow into purpose.
I decree my purpose shall manifest. Nothing shall stop it. Nothing shall hinder it. Nothing shall hold it back. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I want you to see the number on your screen right now, and I want you to go there, and I want you to sow $120 tonight. They were in the upper room, Dr. Medina. The 120. Everybody's been talking about it tonight. And that was the place. That was the place where purpose came to life. That was the place with the 120 where the purpose came to life. Go right now, 85573-WORD, and sow into purpose tonight. You are sowing into your future. You are sowing into the prophetic portrait. How many of you know a good portrait costs a lot of money?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
You can't be cheap. If you want to look crazy, buy you a cheap portrait.
My God, that's right. That's right.
But if you want your future to be filled with purpose and look just the way God wants it to, you sow tonight and you believe God. And I dare you to put on that seed tonight, my purpose fulfilled.
My God.
My purpose fulfilled.
Yes. And you are funding ministry.
Yes.
You are sending the word of God around the world. I don't play games when it comes to seed sowing, and even with the team that came on here.
Exactly.
And say, you're going to get to this special part. I don't play them kind of games. I'm not going to hell for nobody.
Right.
But I do believe in the word of God, the principles in the Bible. As long as the earth remains, there'll be seed, time, and harvest.
Yes, yes.
And this message is going around the world, bringing, come on here, the truth of God to the nations. And you said this thing. You said, fiercely focus forward. I want you to take what the woman of God
God has said. Because remember, like I said, you cannot take them and put them in your pocketbook and say, prophesy to me. Nor do I believe you should run around chasing prophets for somebody to prophesy to you when you have the 66 books prophesying to you. Amen. The B-I-B-L-E. Yes. Amen. The biggest thing that you got to do is remember and keep the word that God gave you and don't allow the devil to steal
it.
And the way he steals it is through distraction, through the cares of this world, the things that come on here, the sideshows that he puts on. But when we decide to focus and keep our eyes on Jesus, purpose all the way, purpose all the way. And that word that Bishop gave us on this Sunday morning, Bishop Oren told us, listen, in the middle of the year, saying for the second quarter, God's going to cause you to see 10 years worth of accomplishment. Come on here. 10 years. It's going to happen in 6 months. And I've seen God do some amazing things. Our church has seen God do amazing things. We were able to close on 16 deeds in a day. You said you closed. Come on here. You said you sowed a seed into purpose, and you were able to be standing in the same place in less than 6 months. There's something about the 6 months. Something between July and December the 31st. It's going to break loose. You're talking about uncommon deals, divine connections. You better give God praise in this place, because the record breaker, the record breaking anointing is on you. Give God praise for Pastor Jenny Hunt. We're fiercely focusing forward.
He gonna use the woman of God that can go hood to harbor to Holy Ghost all in 60 seconds. Who am I talking to?
Before anybody knew your name, that's where you and God had that thing going on. And sometimes you need a good pain to push you back to your closet.
The prophetic that's gonna begin to come from your spirit is going to astound and shift a generation.
When you show up, good shows up. When you show up in a bad, confusing situation, tell your neighbor, I am the solution. The church focuses on the problem, but the kingdom goes with the solution.
You have the audacity to believe you can get it back again, that you can get it better than before. Hallelujah, that God will do greater than your past. He's outdoing history. He's outdoing history.
Well, it's an amazing night here at Medina Pullins Live. My God. Woo! Good God Almighty, Pastor Jenny preached up in here, up in here, up in here. Make you want to slap somebody. Now, you can't do that. Our next guest is here with us. She was here a few weeks ago. Tell you turned the place upside down. God used her in a mighty way. I want you to help me welcome Prophetess Tiffany Moria. Come on, let's welcome her. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me. You know I love you so much.
I love you more. I love you more. Girl, you were here with us a few weeks ago, and I'm telling you, how I'm up here. I keep pushing Erica Campbell's book. I don't know why it's on my mind tonight. It's coming. It's not even released yet. More than pretty. You're more than pretty. You've got an anointing that is second to none. Prophetic accuracy rests on your life. We are so delighted to have you here tonight. So tonight, we've been talking all about the presence of God, talking about purpose. Woman of God, what has the Lord been saying to you concerning this season?
Well, as I heard Prophetess Linda going forth, what she said really resonated in my spirit, and the Lord began to download to me when I was in my seat, and he said, I'm getting ready to release the elements. The four elements, three of the four elements. She released the element of air and wind. Mm. And he said, I'm about to release fire and water. He said, I'm about to release fire and water. He said, it was her assignment, yes, God, to release the element of wind when she discussed Ezekiel. But God said, he dropped in my spirit 1 Kings 18, where Elijah called forth fire and then water. Yes, God. And the Lord told me, he said that this is a season of outpour, great outpour. But before there can be an abundance of rain, there has to be fire that comes down to the earth realm. And so when we look at the fire was a supernatural manifestation manifestation, hallelujah, of the power of God. And what it really did was it sanitized the prophetic and purified the prophetic. And the Spirit of Grace says to me tonight that I am sanitizing, I am sanitizing and purifying the prophetic. The Lord says that this is a season and an hour of the reinstatement of the prophets and the apostles. The apostolic and the prophetic is getting ready to come in the earth realm. And the Lord says that I shall raise up, hallelujah, true prophets. When you look at the prophet Elijah, he came on the scene with no introduction. Nobody knew where he came from. Nobody knew about a mother. He didn't come from an elite family. The Lord says that I'm getting ready to raise up new voices, fresh voices in this season and in this hour that carry a true prophetic anointing and a true prophetic mantle. I'm not talking about word of knowledge where I can tell you where you live and I can tell you your name and I can tell you all of these other things, because psychics can do that. We need to know what the source is. Hallelujah. And the Spirit of the Lord says, yes, God, that I'm raising people that come from the correct source, that are pulling information, prophetic downloads from the correct source. The Bible says that before he produced fire, yes, God, before he produced fire, he prayed.
Come on.
Today we have prophets that are producing that are producing the semblance of fire. It looks like fire, but they are not praying.
Come on, come on.
And God says that as you begin to pray, I shall cause you to even step into another realm, in the realm of the spirit. I shall cause you to step into a supernatural realm. Hallelujah. Even I talked about on the Dorinda show yesterday that when Peter stepped out of the boat, he stepped into another realm. When he walked on water. And God says that even as you pray and as you begin to build altars before the Lord, I shall cause you to step into another realm. I shall raise new fresh voices. He was a fresh voice that came on the scene with no introduction. But one thing we have to understand is that with fresh voices also come false voices.
Come on.
With the fresh comes the false. And God is giving, hallelujah, he's even releasing discernment to the body of Christ, because we have been bewitched and we have been bamboozled. But the Lord says that I shall even cause a stirring. I shall even cause a stirring in your spirit that as you pray, you shall be able to identify what comes from the witch and what comes from the prophet, what comes from Baal and what comes from the spirit of Elijah. What comes from God? God is causing, hallelujah, you to know, I hear him say.
Come on.
I'm causing you to know. The Bible says that even Paul said, hallelujah, I know a man 14 years ago, whether he was in body or not, I'm not sure. But he was taken up to the third heaven. And when he was taken up to the third heaven, he heard inexpressible things. The Lord says that before there can be supernatural demonstration, there has to be supernatural revelation. You cannot demonstrate what has not been revealed to you. And the Lord says that I'm causing you, hallelujah, to encounter a divine revelation as you seek my face and as you build altars of the Lord in your house. That as you build altars, I hear him say that you will tear down altars of Baal and tear down altars of false prophets and tear down false movements in prayer. He came on the scene with no introduction. We're just talking. He came on the scene with no introduction. I don't know who I'm under, Babo Shandalabaha. I don't know who I'm talking to, but the Lord says this is a season, hour for you not to chase platforms.
Come on.
Many people have chased platforms, and because of that, they have had to compromise the authenticity of their mantle and the authenticity of their assignment. Uh-huh. God says that promotion does not come from the north, south, the east, or the west, but it comes from me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. And so with that fresh voice, hallelujah, came a fresh movement. Let me tell you something. When we talk about the prophetic is not always a house and a car. The prophetic is not always something that feel good. But when you are a real prophet, you come to disrupt systems. You come to disrupt wickedness in high places. You come to call down principalities. And the Lord says that I will give you a grace to pull down principalities that even rest over regions. Principalities, hallelujah, that are congregating with other principalities that are causing regions never to even receive the word of God and the manifestation of God. You, yes, you. The Lord says, yes, you. I know that you think that God can't use you because you had an abortion. You think that God can't. Yes, I said it. You think that God can't use you because you went through all of these other things.
fresh. Somebody, wherever you are, shout fresh, 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 fresh. I feel fresh brewing in Alamarosukamantaya. I feel fresh brewing in the atmosphere. I feel fresh brewing in the atmosphere. Fresh oil, fresh revelation, and fresh fire. Fresh, fresh, fresh. So the Bible says that at the mouth of a prophet, the earth, the heavens were shut up for 3.5 years. But at the voice, at the mouth of a true prophet, what was shut up became open. Let me tell you something. God sent the prophets here for a reason.
Oh, yeah.
Because what was shut up, hallelujah, is about to be open. It's about to tear open. Hallelujah. Every prophet had their own assignment to release and declare. But God said that I'm about to, hallelujah. It says that 7 times.
Come on.
After he spoke the word, he and just minor, he at the word of it, at the word of it, it wasn't released immediately. And so sometimes, I forgot who said it, the appointed time, yes, the prophetess, the first time, she said that you have to deal like it's the sons of Issachar. You have to know the seasons and the times. Just because God said it and it wasn't released immediately doesn't mean it's not coming. You've got to linger a while. Thank you, Lord. You got to stay there a while. You released it on, you prayed and God released it the first time that you prayed. And then you got up and said, maybe I missed God. No, linger for a while.
My God.
7 times.
Thank you, Jesus.
7 times they had to look before it was released. Can I tell you something? In the 7th month, we are approaching the 7th month, July. Can you open your mouth wherever you are? I hear the Lord say that by July, what was shut up is about to open. Come on. That what was shut up, that there is a rain that's about to come, that fire, hallelujah, that fire and water is getting ready to be released, that not only fire in the form of judgment, but even fire in the form of passion is about to be released. There are some of you that have been under strong warfare and you have lost your passion behind the warfare that you have dealt with. But the Lord says that I shall even restore your passion. I shall restore your revelation and I shall restore your oil. There's a great rain coming.
Thank you, Jesus.
There's a great rain coming. There's a grandaba koshanda la baba bande kele berosai. There is a grandaba koshanda mansoko ndala bahai ala mansoko rebebebe kosu zebe koshandai. There is a great a rain coming. I got 1 minute. He come on, so girl right there wiping your eyes. As I was sitting in my seat, the Lord says, daughter, you are getting ready to encounter a season of restoration. For the Spirit of the Lord says, you have lost many things. And you are even at a place in your life where you are saying, God, I don't know what to do right now. I'm in a crunch, but the Spirit of grace says today that I shall, hallelujah, reestablish, I shall reaffirm, and I shall reposition. And even the thing that they did to you, that they fought it, come out, Shandala, was going to kill you. The Lord says, hallelujah, that you're coming out of the fire with no damage. That you're coming out of the fire with no damage. There will be no smoke in your clothes. And I hear the Lord say, as you go, don't look back.
Hallelujah.
I got to go. My time is up.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody praise him for the elements. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're getting your joy back, getting your peace back, getting your prayer life back. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's praise God for this woman of God. Woman of God, you said it right. It's not about the credit card number that they reveal. It's not about telling you your name that you already know. But it's about identifying the source of where it comes from. And I don't need no witches prophesying to me. Oh, God. I don't need no strange spirit speaking to me. Hallelujah.
But God brought you here tonight with the prophets. He brought you here tonight with authentic prophetics that are here tonight, authentic prophets, people that sit at the feet of Jesus, not for you to chase prophets, but for you to be fortified even the more in your personal relationship with God, and for you to be able to know and discern what is God and what is not. And to be able, like you said, the prophet was able to say the rain was coming. But that word did not come from what was happening in the atmosphere. The sky didn't prophesy that to him. The sky didn't reveal that. He received that in the spirit. He heard it in the spirit. See, you are the people that can go into the valley of dry bones, and you can go into the place where nothing is happening and make something happen, because you have already received in the presence of God. So you're not looking to flesh to consult with, to see what God is saying, but you look to God to see what he is saying. And then you tell the flesh, and you tell the mountain, and you tell the valley, and you tell the bones, and you tell the situation what it shall be. You need to slap somebody high five and say, it's on, it's on. We're going to infiltrate systems, yes we are. We're going to change cities, yes we are. We're going to change nations, yes we are. Somebody give God praise based on what you heard him say in the spirit. Put your hands together. Prophetess Tiffany Moria, come on, let's bless God. I'm so proud of this one right here. Oh yes, God is using her. And I love what you said about how there was no introduction. You don't need an introduction when you have the real power. Yes. Because the real power of God cannot be denied. Yes. The real presence of God cannot be denied. People healed, delivered, and set free cannot be denied. Yes. You need to open up your mouth, because an undeniable anointing is upon you. Give the Lord praise tonight. It's been a great night. Sow your seed.